Hey, good day, everybody. I had to cut on my air conditioning. It's starting to get a little hot. Anyhow, welcome to another video. I'm going to be doing a video of Oberlin, Ohio. Now, here's a look. Now, Oberlin, Ohio is 40 minutes away from, it is 40 minutes, I'll just say it's 40 minutes south of Cleveland. ...16 miles south of Elyria. And 22 miles from Lorain. Now, Oberlin, and the population here is 8,132 people. Turn around here because I meant to drive through downtown. Really not a whole lot of activity going on here in Oberlin in terms of population growth. I mean, the population growth here is only at 0.2% as of the 2020 census. So here in Oberlin, I mean, honestly, this city for the most part, it's at a standstill in a way. I mean, the good part is it's not getting smaller. That's the good part. Now, houses here are a little more expensive than many other smaller Ohio cities. I mean, the average home price here is set at $175,600, which is significantly more expensive for a home compared to Lorain and Elyria. And there's very few homes that are currently for sale here. I mean, so if you're looking to move to Oberlin and you see a house that you think you want, the best advice I can give you is act fast. Because if you procrastinate, then that house will most likely be gone. The majority of the houses that are currently on the MLS are either contingent or pending, which, as I said before, in this market, that basically means the house most likely has already been sold. It's just a matter of the potential buyer going through what they gotta go through with their bank to close on the offer. Now, Oberlin, Ohio is well known for its art college. It is what I would call an arts town, because, I mean, art is a very big thing here in Oberlin. And a lot of people come to Oberlin because they come here to Oberlin to go to the arts college that happens to be downtown here. And a lot of the entertainment that's here in Oberlin is gonna be around, it's gonna be around art. Now, a few things to do off the top as I wrote down is you can go to the Island Memorial Arts Museum. There's the Oberlin Heritage Center. There's the Common Ground Canopy Tour. And there's also the Apollo Theater. Those are a few things that you can do if you're here in Oberlin. Whether you're gonna move here or you're just gonna be here as a visitor. Now, I guess some people would look at Oberlin and they would consider this a college town. And me personally, I do consider Oberlin to be a college town. I mean, it's a little different than other college towns in my opinion. But, you know, I mean, honestly, Oberlin, you know, it's like I said, I mean, in my opinion, it's a nice little town to live. I mean, it's a nice little city to live in if you got the money for the house, for housing. I mean, if you're not wanting to live in the suburbs and you really don't want to live in Illyrigo or Lorain, and maybe you don't want to live anywhere that's rural, I would say if you're willing and you're able to spend the money on the housing here in Oberlin, Oberlin would definitely be a nice little place to move to. Now, I will say, compared to other college communities, Oberlin is smaller and it's a little quieter. And I don't know if they got this school anymore, but back when I was growing up, there is a school called the Lorain County JVS, which basically is a joint vocational school for those who don't want to go to college and prefer to instead pick up a trade. So if they still got the JVS, it's gonna be here in Oberlin. In fact, it's gonna be right outside of Oberlin. Now, this is the Oberlin College that I'm driving around right now. off the top of my head, I don't know of any neighborhoods here in Oberlin that are considered bad areas or areas that you shouldn't go to at certain hours of the day. So if anyone knows where that area might be, if an area like that even exists, leave a comment below. this is the south side of Oberlin. Looks like a neighborhood, you know. Looks like a normal neighborhood. Normal working class neighborhood, that's what it looks like to me. Just a normal working class neighborhood. Right now I'm on south I'm on Main Street. I'm gonna head to the other side of Oberlin and see what all that looks like. I'm gonna